Get ready to match the star. Jack Carter. Brett Summers. Orson Bean. Louisa Moritz. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Okay.
Not a bad news. She's with me.
You like the floor, don't you?
Yes. You're Louisa. We've had you before here.
I figured if he's speaking.
Yes.
I made a book.
I remember your name, Louisa Moritz, isn't it?
Yes. Yeah. It's like St. Moritz from here. Something in the Alps.
Well, we've had everyone before. You're all regulars, and we welcome you from the bottom of... Hey, listen.
Yes.
What are you doing with that beard on your face?
I tried wearing it on my shoulder. Because...
Juanita Davis is our current show.
Right? Are we on? Yes, we're on. See, what I have to do is push this button, reveal our first round questions, ask Helen to make a selection.
Well, my granddaughter's name is Amanda, so I'll take A.
Okay, please. Helen Kiewit. Here we go. Harvey said...
Yes?
You know, at most motels, you put a quarter in the bed...
Why does he stutter?
Because he's nervous being on television for the first time on the land. And
well, do him like he's been on a couple of times and read it straight.
Okay. He won't stutter now. Harvey said,
yeah.
You know how at most motels you put a quarter in the bed and you get magic fingers?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I know a motel where you put $5 in the bed and get magic blanks. Question. I don't see why you're even thinking about it.
Ask me how blind I am.
How blind are you, Brett?
I'm so blind I asked Louisa where the men's room was.
Boy, are you hard of seeing.
I heard her. She said, say, fellow.
Okay. This is really a... That's it. You got it there. Put it on there. That's it. That's just right here. All right. Yeah, you put it right in the slot there. You remember. Yeah. Okay.
It's too bad her brain isn't the size of her blanks.
Oh, boy. All right. Now, Helen, we've got this for you. Harvey said, you know how at most motels you put a quarter in the bed and get magic fingers? You're familiar with that, aren't you, Helen? Well, he says, I know a motel where you put $5 in the bed and get magic blanks. What do you say to that? You know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
Magic.
See, if you put a quarter in, you get magic fingers. And you put $5 in, and you get magic...
Toes, I guess.
Toes.
Toes.
Okay, Helen, I guess you don't spend much time in motel rooms, do you? Do you?
Motels? Spelled backwards is let 'em. Oh. Well, most motels, the house detective knocks on the door. You got a girl in there? No. So they throw one in.
I see.
For $5, they put ladies in the room.
Ladies in the room.
Magic ladies.
Magic ladies in the room. Okay. Brett, what did you say?
Well, I know that motel.
Yes.
I used to work there.
Oh.
And they take magic girls.
Magic girls.
Not me, because I'm not a girl anymore.
What did you say?
It was a tragic case of a honeymoon couple from Covina who put their life savings into it and got jiggled to death. It was a terrible thing. Magic hands.
Hands is a good answer, you see. Fingers give you a quarter. Hands for, you see, that's it. Hello there.
Hi there.
How are you?
Well,
I just took the example from what I use, and I use magic sheets.
Remind me to stay home.
Really?
Is it supposed to go?
That's not the slot you put it in, my dear. Oh. You put it in. That's the slot you put it in. You're right, Brett. Okay. Oh, good. Come on, more, more. Magic sheets is what she said.
Yes. You gave up the plastic baggies, huh?
Right.
You're saying.
I say, you put a quarter in the bed, get magic fingers. He knows a motel where you put $5 in the bed, get magic blanks.
Magic rug makers.
Really?
Yeah, or hookers.
Okay. Miss Betty, honey, what do you say there, little girl?
I don't know how a nice girl like me got in here.
Lucky out there.
Oh, yes, sir. No, no sheets, but magic tricks.
No one thought of toes, my dear. Now, Juanita, this for you. Gladys wanted her boyfriend to win the 100-yard dash.
How badly did she want her boyfriend to win the...
I'll tell you how badly. Just before the race, yep, she put blank in his shorts.
What?
Gladys wanted her boyfriend to win the 100-yard dash.
Right.
So just before the race, she put blank in his shorts.
Got it.
Okay.
Jeepers. Well, that's an easy one, isn't it?
Did you hear that?
I did.
All right,
yes.
Think about it for a moment or so.
My pen is all funny.
All right, you got two. You got
glad something right is.
Okay.
With tricks, I'd be
all
very
right
careful.
Now, we're ready with Juanita. Gladys wanted her boyfriend to win the 100-yard dash, so just before the race, she put blank in his shorts.
Itching powder.
Itching powder in his shorts. They're groaning at that a little bit, Juanita. Betty said he was starting from scratch. Yes, right. Jack, what'd you say?
Oh, I nearly said itching powder. But I lost the itch, the urge.
Yeah.
Swine for a little Chinese starch.
Starch.
Starch. To give him a stiff start.
Okay. Now, what'd you say, Brett?
I said itching powder.
All right. Well, here there's one for you. Arsenal Bean, what have you got to say?
Like a monkey at a typewriter, you occasionally come up with something worthwhile and readable.
I hope you lose your hair.
Again.
She wanted him really to win that race.
Wanted
really
him to win that race.
She put Tabasco sauce down.
Tabasco sauce. Boy, that'll do it every time. Glass boyfriend wanted to win the 100-yard dash, so just before the race, she put blank in his shorts. What do you say, little girl?
Well, in Cuba...
Excuse me for calling you a little girl, but that's just came to my mind there. What did you say?
Well, little boy...
Yes?
In Cuba, they put garlic. That makes you run. Lots of places.
Garlic makes you run. Okay. All right, Richard.
Present.
So just before the race, you put blank in his shorts.
This is a way to get people to win. You put ants.
Ants in the pants. Okay.
Like your uncles.
Or uncles.
Or uncles, yeah.
And some weird
ants
relatives
in the pants is, seems to be the winner, Betty. What have you got
it's
there?
That's a terrible answer. Ants.
Well
ants
done. Well done.
So, ladies, at the end of round one, our current champion's ahead, 1-0, and round two is going to happen in a moment or so, but first, this has to happen for you. Here we go, ladies, round two coming up. There it is. Helen, would you make a selection?
A again, please.
Now, everybody plays because no one matched in the first round, or she didn't match anyone. Diane said, I don't think I passed my driving test. When I got out of the car, the examiner was blanking. I don't think I passed my driver's test. When I got out of the car, the examiner was blanking.
Hi, dear.
Hello, darling.
I think I understand. I'm not absolutely
you do understand
dead
it.
Sure.
How have you been, Brett?
Oh, I've just been wonderful. I'm
good.
Singing, you know, and taking piano lessons.
Oh, are you? You're doing all of that.
And expect almost momentarily to be in a piano bar in the valley. And that's my idea of dying and going to heaven. He needs me, you know, all that.
Oh, yes,
and I'll accompany myself.
Well, when you're ready to open, I'm going to be there opening night.
Yeah, that's the best night to get her, because she won't go to second night.
Okay. Now, Helen Kiewit. Diane said, I don't think I passed my driving test. When I got out of the car, the examiner was blanking.
Shaking.
Oh, good answer. That's not a bad answer at all. Jack, she says shaking.
Well, that's close. My wife just took a driving test, and she drove through downtown Los Angeles and only hit one thing.
What was that?
Downtown Los Angeles. And the guy was sitting there crying.
Crying?
Right.
That's another good answer.
Bawling, bawling.
Very good. Brett?
I don't know whether this is a match or not. It may very well be. He was having the vapors, which is very much like a shaking.
Well, that's close to shaking, but having the vapors, it is.
Oh, it is.
Uh-huh. Yeah, that's right. Okay.
Vapors.
Having the vapors, it's a Victorian expression. We used to say
it's
that.
It's a resort.
They had a hole in their muscles.
Orson, what'd you say?
The vapors.
Having the vapors.
No, it's the Goyish equivalent of a condition.
Yes.
Lasts for years, exactly. And it's impossible. All right. He was angry.
I see. Okay. He was really shaky. When I got out of the car, the examiner was blanking.
I said recovering.
Oh, adorable.
Recovering.
That is a match.
Is that a match?
I heard a bell ring.
No?
Bell that went off.
Right. Oh, what are you doing?
A bell. A bell goes ding. Buzzer goes.
It's a bird.
What one did she hear?
That's what she heard.
See? Okay. You're right, it is a bell.
Yes. When I got out of the car, the examiner was blanking.
He was praying.
Oh. Praying. Another good answer.
Right.
What was that examiner doing, Betty White?
We may have to have a meeting. We may, because having the vapors is very much like fainting. And fainting.
Fainting is not shaking. When you're shaking, I mean, when you're fainted, you're just lying there prone. You can't
do anything. You put $5 in the machine and see what happens to you.
Now, where are we?
You're with friend.
1-1. Oh, all you need is one to win the game.
As a host.
Ready? Here we go. At the party, Steve said, gee, it's getting damp in here. And Mildred said, no, it's not. You're so drunk, you're standing in the blank. At the party, Steve said, gee, it's getting damp in here. And Mildred said, no, it's not. You're so drunk, you're standing in the blank.
Oh, I got it.
That's an easy one, right? Okay. Right. Good, good, good. Finished, finished, finished. All right, here we go. Juanita, you need one to win. At the party, Steve said, gee, it's getting damp in here. And Mildred said, no, it's not. You're so drunk, you're standing in the...
shower.
Shower. Shower, she said. Jack?
Oh, that's the guy comes home and finds the guy nude in the shower. What are you doing here? He says, I'm voting. I'm a nudist. Came in and take a quick... No, I said in the punch bowl.
In the punch bowl. She says shower. Brett, what do
you
say?
Well, we may have to have...
Oh, she matched already. Yeah, you matched in the first round.
Well, that's silly.
Tear it out.
Papers. All right. Says don't write there in plain English.
Right. That's important.
I don't see. That's why I don't write.
Orson?
No, he was so drunk he was standing in the toilet bowl.
I see. They're applauding that. She says, you're so drunk you were standing in the, and she says shower.
Bathtub.
How about that? Bathtub and shower.
Together.
Is that a match? Bathtub and shower. What do you have, Richard? Joydy, Betty, what do you have? Shower. Okay, here we go. Come on down, Juanita. Another $100 for you, and we'll say goodbye to Helen Kiewit. Helen, it was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you.
We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being with us here on Match Game 74. Helen Kiewit. Goodbye. We'll get to you in a moment or so, but right now we've got to get to this. Here we are. We're up here with Juanita Davis. This is her second time up here. She's got $200 now. She could win over $5,000 at this point. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, Juanita. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank beauty. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250. The third, $100. Three celebrities are allowed to help. Whom do you choose?
Okay, Richard.
Sleeping Beauty.
Sleeping Beauty is one.
Betty.
You, Betty White?
Betty, one? Yes.
All right.
Black Beauty.
Black Beauty?
Black Beauty.
And Brett.
Brett.
How about Bathing Beauty?
Bathing Beauty. Well, you got three there. Bathing Beauty, Black Beauty, and Sleeping Beauty. Do you want one of those, or do you want to give us one of your own?
Sleeping Beauty.
Sleeping Beauty is the one she's looking for. She hopes that's up there under the $500 response. But we'll start down at the bottom and take a look at the $100 response. Raving Beauty.
Raving? Oh, Raving Beauty. They must have been thinking about little old me.
That's right. All the time.
That's raving.
Looking
bad.
For Sleeping Beauty. Here's the $250 response. Sleeping Beauty, you've got it. Congratulations to you, Juanita.
Black Beauty, eh?
What's up there?
I don't know. I thought Sleeping Black.
Black Beauty?
Black.
I'm so sure it's Sleeping, I'll still bet it, even though I see it ain't there.
Shh. A wall has spoken.
Show. Black Beauty's right. Okay. Black Beauty it is. All right. Now you've got 250. You're going to play for 10 times that amount or 2,500. To collect, you got to match one of them. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. Here's the $2,500 question. Blank price. P-R-I-C-E. Blank price. Okay, he's got one. Now, Juanita, it's up to you to give us an answer which you think will match his. What do you say to that? Blank price.
The only thing I think of is right price.
Right price. The audience is owing you. They're saying, you're owing yourself.
Yes.
Go for yourself.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. It's a rotten answer.
I know.
But you never know. Once in a while, he gives a rotten answer, too. And the two rotten answers could match. He doesn't often give a rotten answer because he's a very good game player.
Well, I did once give Benedict Canyon.
That's right.
Instead of grand, I did feel rather foolish.
She says right price to match you, Richard. For $2,500, may we see
it. It's really a toughie, Don. And the only thing I could think of is what Brett charges, and that's half.
Half price. Half price? Okay.
Price for your edification.
Did you have right price?
But is there one biggie that anyone...
Well, I would have said Vincent Price. What would you have said?
I had that too.
Wholesale price? Yeah. What would you have said?
Right price, wrong girl.
Half price? Yeah. Okay. All right. So now, listen, you're up to... how much money have you got now? $450. You're going to play another game. You ready for that?
I'm ready.
Let's meet your next player, Martha Marie Pate. Juanita, I've got to ask you about your name, Martha Marie. I've never seen that name before. How did that happen?
Thank you. Well, I'll make a long story short.
Yes?
My mother was born at home.
Yep.
It's her name. And the nurse asked my grandmother, what do you want to name her? So she said, I'll name her after my mother, Martha, and my aunt, Marie. But being Bostonian, it came out Martha Marie, and the nurse wrote it down that way. And,
that's on your birth certificate, Martha Marie.
Martha Marie.
They say that in the East, in
yes.
around Boston.
Yes.
Instead of Martha, they say Martha.
Martha.
Yeah.
Martha.
Right.
Well, you were lucky, you know, because your mother could have answered, what do you want to name her? And your mother could have said, God knows. You would have had that for a minute.
Where do you live now?
I'm a native Californian here in North Hollywood.
Yeah.
And my favorite pastime is trying to please a spiffy husband and four teenagers, 13 to 17.
You have four teenagers?
Yes. And
four? And are you...
And a surprise.
Oh. I thought there was more than one of her there.
Gene, when did they have time to name her?
I'm glad to hear all that. Martha Marie and Juanita, we'll come back to you in a moment or so, but right now we've got to go to you and present this message. Ladies, we've got to stop right here now and look forward to seeing you next time when we'll start a brand new game with Juanita and Martha Marie. Okay? Listen, I just want to say you are terrific, everyone, each in his own way. Everyone made a contribution of one kind or another, and it was just splendid to have all of you here.
Here's my card if you're ever in the valley.
Okay.
Tales next over most of the CBS stations.